Welcome to Dormet Dining. I'm Nicole Cormier, registered dietitian. Today we're going to be making a quinoa mac and cheese. So we're taking your traditional macaroni and cheese and we're going to replace the macaroni part with our quinoa. Quinoa can be found in the rice aisle of your supermarket. There's several different brands to choose from. This is from Roland's and it's a roasted garlic, so it's actually going to add an additional flavor to our macaroni and cheese or quinoa and cheese. The great thing about quinoa is that it's an ancient grain that is technically a seed, so it has a lot of different amino acids, which is a protein. So it's a complete protein and it has a lot of fiber there too. So it's really going to help balance your blood sugars and keep you fuller for a longer period of time. You can actually cook the quinoa in a microwave. Even if the instructions say it has to be done over the stove, you can add just the same amount, 1 cup quinoa to 2 cups water, and put it in the microwave until all of the water is absorbed. The time will differ depending on the power of your microwave. So start off with 5 minutes and go up to 15 minutes depending on the power. But just as soon as all of the water is absorbed, your quinoa will it will puff out just a little bit and you'll see a small sprout because it's a seed, and that will let you know that it's finished, okay? Okay, so after your quinoa is cooked and really nice and warm, we're gonna add our cheese next. So we're gonna add 2 different types of cheeses. You can either use any type of spreadable cheese. So you could use a cream cheese or the Neuchâtel cheese, which is Cabot has a nice brand, and I believe there's a couple other brands that you might see in the supermarket as well. So it's very similar to a cream cheese. We're gonna add half of it to a bowl to mix, and we're gonna put the quinoa right on top of it so it will help melt or start the process of melting that cheese. Okay, so just use a medium mixing bowl. Our next cheese that we're gonna use is a Cabot mozzarella cheese. So this is really going to add an additional protein to our meal. Okay, and then we're going to actually add a vegetable to our quinoa and cheese, and this is going to be shredded carrots. So you can start off with a handful or a half of a cup. Okay. And you're just gonna take a spoon and start mixing the entire mixture up until all of the cheese has spread evenly throughout the quinoa and is melted in a smooth melted consistency. And so we have our plate where we're going to take Boston lettuce. Is a very unique lettuce where it's very delicate, it's soft, but if you just gently remove the leaves, you can make them into little serving cups. Okay. And we'll take our quinoa and cheese. So this could actually be an appetizer for an event that you have coming up or a get together, or it could simply be a really quick and easy way for you to get away from your traditional processed macaroni and cheese to a protein and fiber quinoa and cheese. Okay, so this one recipe makes 4 servings. As shown right here. And we have created our quinoa mac and cheese, a great protein and fiber for a complete lunch, snack, or appetizer. Thank you for watching.